I'm an epidemiologist, and when I was a kid, I loved math and science. Challenge was, when I was a college student and did science, I found that it was too abstract. It didn't feel like I was going to touch people and impact people. But luckily, before the end of my first year of medical school, there was this amazing class in epidemiology. It involved math and science and people and talking to people, and it involved having an impact on more than one person at a time. An epidemiologist finds out why some people get sick and why others don't, and tries to figure out what to do about it. We deal with math and statistics, we talk to people, we find out what their eating habits are, where they've been, what sorts of things in the environment affect them, and then we figure out how we can prevent more people from getting sick. I've had the opportunity to research various different diseases, to travel to lots of different countries, to work with people with lots of different backgrounds, and to learn about the contributions of other folks, like communications folks, educators, policymakers, other scientists. One of the things that I've learned is that it's not enough to be good at science. To make sure that your science makes a difference, you also have to have and cultivate the softer skills. You have to be able to get along with people. You have to be able to communicate your science. You have to be able to work and understand other perspectives to make your science stick. The advice I would give to young women, just thinking about my history, is that science is great. It opens doors to so many things. Leadership, policy. I'm pretty much a teacher now, and I love it. I also might say that it's okay to be different.